As you can see, I didn't want to draw focus away from the product. Definitely wasn't a camera error. Anyway, back to the product. Well, Sonic are back with the Gizmo Mark IIs. Just like the previous Gizmos, these are absolutely jam-packed full of features. So in this video, I'm going to tell you five key things you need to know about the Gizmo Mark IIs. Now, one of the standout features of the original Gizmos was the illuminated snag ears. Now, there were the slight gripes from some people that had them that they couldn't quite see them in bright daylight days like today. So Sonic have listened, and that's one of the first things they've addressed, because we still have the illuminated snag ears where they are much, much brighter. So as you can see, even in the bright sunlight that we've got today, the blue is lit up on there. Now, these colours can be changed. There's actually six different colours available. You've got red, green, blue, purple, orange and white, I believe I've got those correct. And they are also adjustable in brightness levels. So at the moment I've got this on this brightest setting because glorious sunshine, but if I wanted I could dull them down. And that goes the same for the LEDs on the front. We've got four different LED illumination settings, one of which is completely off. So if you didn't want these to light up and the LEDs to light up, you can have them off and you can go through from low, medium to high, and of course off. So that's really handy that they've rectified that issue. They've listened to you guys and made that one of those features that is actually going to stand out both day and night. Now, I'm aware I start on the visual aspect of these alarms, but the core function of any bite alarm is that they go beep when you get a bite. And they do that, and they do it well, because the speaker has been upgraded from the previous model and you've got a tone range from very low to very high, and all of which is nice and clear, crisp, and packs a bit of a punch. Now, I have already done some test settings on this on the lake. I'm not going to annoy the anglers once again by doing it, but just to show you very quickly that the tone functions, it goes from a nice low one like this. Might have to turn up a little bit more for you to hear it. All the way up. So a very high pitch one. So if you like a low tone, more of an old school sound, or you like a high pitch one that's quite piercing and it's going to wake you up even in the deepest of sleeps, then the sound is absolutely spot on from these alarms. Of this being Sonic, they don't just beep and light up like most alarms, they are packed full of features as well, and as always, at a good price point as well, which I'll get onto later on. But to start with, something as simple as a hard case. Now this one, hard plastic case, keeps it nice and protected during transit, but it also serves another function, because at the moment, this alarm head is completely off, and if you look at these alarms all over, there are no on-off buttons anywhere. But as soon as I take that case off, this alarm is now live. Put the case back on, you'll get a little beep. That's telling me it's now off. So in transit, it protects it and makes sure that you don't run the battery down by leaving them on by accident. So as long as you don't lose the case, you can rest assured that your alarm head is always going to be off when in transit. Moving on to the alarms themselves, once those cases are off, actually I keep this one in my hand and turn that volume down so it doesn't keep beeping. On the inside, we've got a nice rubber inlay, so it protects your rod and keeps it nice and grippy as well. The snag ears, as well as lighting up, actually serve another function that if you get violent takes from left to right, it's going to make sure your rod doesn't pull off that alarm and fall off, so that's really handy as well. Lovely rubberized sort of textured finish. On the back, very easy to access battery compartment, and as you can see, they take three AAAs. Slide that case back on, and underneath we've got a 2.5mm out socket for illuminated hangers. Now the front is very simplistic as well. Three dials and extremely easy to use. You've got sensitivity, tone and volume, all fairly self-explanatory. They also have two other buttons, the F, which is function, and L, which is light. Now I'll start with the F button because that has a intelligent mute setting. So as soon as I press that F button, as you can see, the snag ears are now flashing for me. And if I twiddle the line through the alarm, there is no noise. That is bliss, because for those of you that like to fiddle with your alarms once the rod's in situ, I'm actually using adjustable zigs today, so it's quite handy that I can do this, because I can pay off a bit of line if I wanted, if I want to bring the zig up, or bring some line back if I want to bring the zig back down, making no noise. And after a certain amount of time, that will automatically turn itself back on. Or if I press the F button again, we are now back into live mode. So it's actually giving me indication. But also, if I press and hold that F button, it will open me up into the channel of LED color on the snag ears. And that's how you rattle through the different colors on your alarm head. And once you've got to the color you want to use, I'm using blue at the moment, leave it. And that will then automatically set and keep it there for you. The L button is light, so just a press on that and you rattle through the different illumination levels of the LEDs and the snag ears, from completely off, so at the moment I've got nothing, whereas if I go through it again, that's two, 3 and 4, that's now on its brightest. So even in the brightest daylight, as I've already mentioned, that you can see those LEDs. But that L button also does something else, a double press, and you may not notice it in the daylight, but that's because this is something that's going to come into its own, go into the evening and the night. I have now just turned on the night glow feature, which automatically is the same color as whatever you've set that alarm head to, but it's a really dim level of light. So it's not going to be shown at the moment, but coming into the evening and night, it's just a perfect level of light emitted from your alarms, showing you where they are, but it's also pretty cool in it. Night lights are pretty cool in your alarm. Double press it again and that's now off, so I'm not wasting the power on that during the day. Now when it comes to actually getting indication from a carp, as you can see from that very intro take, you've got a differentiation between drop back and going forward. So forwards is just a single tone like so, and if I drop back you've got two much shorter bursts of beeps, so you know whether you're getting a drop back or a forward take, which is very, very handy, so you know exactly what's going on at any time. And the last thing of note is that these are fully sealed cases. Proof in that, and actual test in that, is that this morning, when I knelt down here to put these sticks in, I dropped one and one went straight into the margin. Bubbles were coming up from the case and I thought, balls, I've got to film these and I may have just buggered one already. But I picked it up and it worked absolutely fine. So rest assured, if you drop it in the margin, as long as you still reach it, you should be good. And of course, that's going to make sure that it's going to be perfectly weather sealed for any conditions that the British weather, or in fact anywhere else, can throw at it. Now the kit I've got with me today is actually a 3 plus 1 plus 1, I suppose, because it's 3 alarm heads, receiver and a bivy light. So moving on to the receiver, to start with, very easy on off. You've got a little switch at the top, that's now on, flick it back and that's now off. Now if I turn it on, I've got about 6 ducks in my swim at the moment, so apologies for that if they get in the camera. Turn that on, you then illuminated LEDs at the very top. Now these automatically sync to your alarm head. So at the moment this one's blue, and as you can see, blue came through on there, and this one is also blue, so it's actually come through on the same, and that's extremely loud, so I'm going to turn that down, but there's 6 volume modes on there as we're talking about it. So that's going on to its loudest, and this is now on mute. So if I do that again, just the alarm head's gone off, this has vibrated. So it has a vibrate mode as well. You can have it on loud, no vibrate, silent with vibrate, noise and vibrate, or completely silent and just LEDs, completely catered to yourself. So if you want to have alarm heads completely muted and no LEDs, this completely muted, just vibrates, you're nice and stealthy, you can do so. Or you can have everything kicking off at once so that you're definitely not going to miss a bite in the middle of the night. Moving on to the front, 4 buttons, nice and easy to use. The first of which, top left, is a little torch function. Something I didn't think I'd ever really use. I was actually using these on a session earlier on this week, and I didn't have my head torch to hand, and it was actually really handy. It was in my pocket. I thought I just need to find where a few things are in my bag, and that did come into use. So something I never thought I'd really use with a receiver, but it does come into use every now and then. To the right of that is an M button. That's mode, so you can also change whether you're on the vibrate, noise, no noise or anything. That's what I've just gone through. And it also is a memory function. So press that, it's telling me that the second alarm that's synced onto here is the one that's just beeped. So that's nice, it's got that. And this also has a drop back and forward take illumination. So if I go forward, if I put it next to here, you can see it's lit up blue. If I drop back, it's flashing as well. So it tells me on the receiver, just as well as it does on the alarm head, whether it's a forward take or a drop back. Everything is automatically synced. I forgot to mention that. As soon as I took these out of the bag, they were already synced. Now there is an S button on there. If anything ever happened where they fell out of sync, you just press and hold the S button, and then as you take the cases off each alarm, they automatically ping across here. So it's dead simple to resync, but it should come pre-synced. And anything I change on the alarm head, whether that be the tone or the color, automatically goes across to this. So if I turn the volume back up on the receiver, as you can hear this one, if I put it on the lowest tone, will now come across as a low tone. And if I turn this alarm head all the way up to its high pitch tone, already coming through in its high pitch. I'm going to turn that back down. So everything you do, really intelligent. You don't have to faff around changing this to make sure it matches. It just does it automatically really, really quickly. Freestanding. Ooh, maybe not on my hand because my hand's not flat, but sits on a bivy table perfectly. Comes with a little lanyard, you can hang that as well. And it's a nice size to fit in the palm, chuck in your pocket, and does everything you need a receiver to do. And also, you've got a range of up to 200 meters. Now, every time we mention the range of a receiver, people go, you should never be that far from your rods. We know that. It just shows how powerful the receiver is. So if I was in the swim next door of a mate, I know that's gonna pick it up. If I was a few swims down, it should still work. Or if it's a really densely wooded area, it's a strong enough receiver, it should reach. We do not advocate being that far from your rods, okay? And then moving on to the BV light as well. Much the same as the receivers, this automatically syncs up to my alarms. It's off at the moment, but if I turn it back on, that is now on. You can have this fully manual, so if you want to use this as a standalone BV light, you can turn it on or turn it off, or you can have it as it is at the moment, so that when I get a take, it illuminates like so. And in the middle there, you may not be able to see it as well because it's bright sunshine. It's come up blue in the middle because that's the alarm that's gone off. Again, if I change the alarm head color to red or purple or something, automatically without touching anything, it comes across as that color for me. Brightness settings can be changed. A delay setting can be changed. So if you want this to illuminate when you get a few beeps on your alarms, you only want it on for a few seconds, you can do so. Or if you want it on for closer to a minute, you can ramp it up as long as you like, so you know exactly where everything is with your bivvy being illuminated. And as I said, that can still be used as a standalone bivvy light as well. It can mount to your bivvy with either a magnetic plate, or if you take that magnetic plate off, underneath is a hook, so you can hang that in your bivvy as well. It's a really handy little bivvy light, and that comes included, which I think Sonic have always really done, include a bivvy light, which is a nice little feature. And the fact that it's not just a bivvy light, it works in conjunction with your alarm heads, is a very nice feature indeed. And one other thing that these two items have in common is a silent low battery warning. So rather than things making a noise and using more power and being really annoying, it will just be flashing saying, give me a charge please. The receiver takes 3 AAAs, whereas the bivvy light is fully rechargeable with a 2000 milliamp battery inside and it's charged by USB-C. So that's nice and easy. You can charge that on the bank. Most of us take a power pack with us now, so if this did die on a session, recharge it. And AAAs, have a few spare in your bag, or if you do are in a pinch, I'm sure your local petrol station in any lake, if it's in the middle of nowhere, will have some AAAs to get you covered with the receiver and the alarm heads. And lastly, the prices. As of everything we've found with Sonic over the last few years, their value for money is one of the main things that they really strive for. And all those things that I've just shown you today, and probably much more, so do go ahead and look at them on the website if you want a bit more information, comes in at a very reasonable price of £289.99 RRP. And that's for the 3 plus 1 plus 1 set I've got with me today. If you went for a 2 plus 1 plus 1, you're looking at £239.99. And if you went for a 4 plus 1, you're looking at £339.99 RRP. But of course, not everyone wants to get a full set like this. They might just want a single alarm head. Or if you're gonna have a few alarm heads at a later date, you then wanna get a receiver, you can do so. The alarm heads come in at just £64.99 each, which I think is a very, very good price point for such a high tech and high functionality alarm. And then the receiver comes in at £69.99, so you can get that at a later date if you've already got the alarm heads. So please do head over to the Sonic website and check these out if I haven't given you enough information in this video. They are one of their higher end items, but they are absolutely packed full of features. And I'm sure if you got your hands on some and felt them, you'd be very impressed yourself as well. So cheers for watching, and I'll see you again soon.